Hello guys, welcome back to the channel, and today we are looking at this Harley Benton R-458 BK model. So, as I'm sure most of you guys know, Harley Benton is the house brand of a musical shop in Europe called Thomann. Thomann is a really, really big musical shop in all of Europe. People sometimes will say it's a guitar center of Europe. It's just a really big brand over there, and they have their own line of guitars called Harley Benton. Benton is reasonably well known for being decent quality instruments for ridiculously cheap prices, like ridiculously cheap prices, absurdly cheap prices for what it is. Just by example, we have this guy here, which is an 8-string guitar, and it was $146 brand new. And if you haven't done research on 8-string guitars in a while, the cheapest one I could find was on AliExpress, and that was $279 or so shipped to my door. And then above and beyond that, there was like RG8s for $250 or $275 used, but those go new for, I believe, $399. So a new 8-string guitar for $150 is literally unheard of besides Harley Benton. Let's quickly get into the specs of it. We have a basswood body. We have two proprietary pickups. We have a three-way toggle switch, a volume and a tone knob, all kind of black. We have their sort of, it looks kind of like a hip shoddy bridge, if you will, but not quite as nice. We have a couple of decent bevels on the body that gives it a little bit of character, but not much character. We have a 24 nickel frets on an Amaranth fretboard, which lies on top of a maple neck, which has a scarf joint right there. And then we have these regular black proprietary tuners, which are fine. And then we have some, you know, basic toilet seat inlays. We have a toilet seat inlay right there. You know, truss rod and a basic, I think it's a plastic nut. Let me look and see real fast. It doesn't say what kind of nut it is. I'm gonna guess it's plastic, which is fine. They say it has a D-shaped neck, which is, that's fair. It's a pretty thin neck. It reminds me of a wizard neck. It basically feels like a wizard neck to me. I would not be surprised if it basically was the same specs of a wizard neck. It feels like a wizard neck. And yeah, so that's that. So let's quickly go into the build quality of the guitar, because you know, the reputation really is decent for the price, and I was curious about the build quality, and I'm sure you guys are too. So it was well made, for sure. I have not set it up yet. I just got it a few days ago. It's not been set up, and you know, everything plays pretty well. The frets are nice and rounded. There's no sharpness at all. Zero sharpness all the way up, which is always pretty impressive. It means they put some time into those frets. You can see on the side here, they actually did round on the fretboard a little bit, which is pretty cool. The setup's okay. I mean, there's a few dead spots down here. More like buzz than dead spots, but there's some buzz down there. It's not a big deal. This came from Germany, and I live in Seattle, so. But that's not really a fret problem. That is a setup problem. All the frets look perfectly fine. It stays in tune pretty well, surprisingly. I will say the 26.5-inch scale length is a little minimalistic for an 8-string guitar. I mean, they do offer a fan fret model of this, but I didn't want to buy that one because I hate active pickups when they're stock. I have never heard a stock pickup that's active that I've liked, besides Agile Cepheus pickups. Those are okay, but even those are a bit muddy, and they're not my favorite. So I got one that had passives, because typically stock passives sound a lot better than stock actives, in my opinion. But yeah, I mean, the finish is fine. I mean, it's a gloss black finish. I don't know. There's no problems with it whatsoever. I don't really. Apparently, they're drag racing outside. One second here. As I was saying, the finish is fine. It's a basic gloss black. I don't know. It was done well. There's no problems with it. It's very fingerprinty. It's like a new cell phone, and touching it, you get fingerprints everywhere, but that's how it goes with like high gloss finishes. There's no tool marks on the fretboard, which is kind of neat. I mean, it looks pretty consistent all the way up. There's some inlays, I guess, which is kind of cool, just for style points. And I mean, it was made fine. I don't know. I think it's one of those things where like a guitar like this, is what you get for the price is going to be something incredibly unextraordinary in terms of how it looks. I mean, this is one of the most ordinary looking guitars I've ever seen in my entire life. In fact, when I got it and pulled it out, my wife was like, that is just such a regular looking guitar. That's okay. It's kind of what you what you get for the price, right, is you don't get like a burl maple, you know, galaxy looking top and like a 9-piece brown, you know, neck with wings. But yeah. Alright, you know, a guitar. So, this guitar, I feel, will serve as a purpose, and that purpose is to be cheap. I need an 8-string, and I need one right now. And I can't save up for the, you know, GOC 8-string or the get a Kiso 8-string. I need just a basic 8-string right now for a project. I don't have very much money. This will serve you very well for that purpose. It's made perfectly fine. So let's get into some tones from these stock pickups. I don't usually expect much from stock pickups, far less if it's $150 for the entire guitar, but let's get into it. I'm gonna do some high gain tones going through Fortin's Nameless, and what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go through a stock preset so we can kinda get an overall sound that you can replicate at home. There's a stock 8-string metal preset on Fortin Nameless, so I'm just gonna go through that and just do some chugging, and I might go through some leads too on my TH3 with my own tone and see how it sounds for leads. And I'm not going to do cleans because it's probably, it's fine for clean. It's clean, so I don't know. So, I mean, overall, what we have here for the money is something that I feel is an extraordinary accomplishment in the sense that it is fine. You could never buy a brand new 8-string guitar for $150 that would be fine before, okay? You couldn't even buy one, period, for that price. I think it's kind of ugly, is the thing about it. I hate these pickup rings. They're hideous. I mean, the headstock is just ridiculous. It looks like someone took the Nike Just Do It logo and just threw it on there and cut it out. I don't understand the logic behind the headstock. It looks terrible. That's just my opinion, of course, but it's just not aesthetic. It doesn't look, the angles are weird. I don't know. Whatever. And yeah, when I see it sitting in the corner of my bedroom, I'm not like inspired to pick it up and play something. And that's kind of like the trade-off of the price point. But beggars can't be choosers, and you get this guitar, and it feels good, it plays well, it sounds fine, it sounds okay. There's no problem with it. It's a little low output, and it's a little muddy, as you heard, but it's not too bad. It's not too bad. So yeah, anyway, in synopsis, I think this is a great guitar for the price, and I'm amazed that they kind of have this now. Like, I know they have more expensive guitars that are 8-string, but, I mean, I'm just really impressed that they have this guitar at the price they have it at. So, yeah, that's the review. Pretty good. Not bad. Kind of boring. not bad. It's kind of like Toby from The Office. It's kind of boring, but not bad. He's fine. It'll do. It does the job just fine. Anyways, thank you so much for watching, guys. I hope you enjoyed the review. Hope it was informative. If you like the guitar, obviously go to Tomon and you can buy it there.